Was it Wozniak who soldered it? Was it Steve Jobs who soldered it? Because these were done in the garage. We know it, to set the boards up so they could run. With this scanning, one of the really cool things that I saw was, you know, we were able to zoom in and see, you know, kind of the remnants of the silk screening of the lettering on the board. And I was able to see, you know, there's wires that were put on in the garage by, could be Jobs, could have been Dan Kottke, could have been Wozniak, but that are used to set settings on the board. I was able to see like the minute soldering of it. And to be honest, this gives me promise that I could probably figure out by looking at some samples who soldered it, because everyone's techniques are slightly different. So when I look at an Apple One to evaluate its condition, after we make sure it's original, we look for things to make sure that we have the original PROMs that have all the code written by Wozniak. We look for the original microprocessor, you know, the white ceramic. We look to make sure the date codes on all of the different components. We make sure that all the capacitors, these little, you know, circular things that are on the board, none of them are chipped or cracked or broken. We make sure that there aren't any cuts on the front of the board. We make sure that we're not missing any pads in the prototype area. We look at the date codes on all the larger components, like the capacitor, like the original power supply regulators. We make sure that they haven't been changed out. We also look for carbon scoring to make sure there hasn't been a fire on the board. Because some of these components, when they go, they catch on fire and it's catastrophic. The Armin technology is so good that I can look at how the components are actually soldered on the board. There are a few pieces which were done by hand. Most were done by this technique called wave soldering. And I use that to see if a component has been changed. But the things that were hand soldered, done in the garage, the nice part is with this technology, I can compare different samples, not just Apple ones, but early prototypes done in Apple, and try and figure out who actually did the work in the garage. With this technology, it's pretty amazing for me, because I look at these things generally through a loop, you know, a jeweler's loop, and some of the details that I might see on like a Patek Philippe watch, zooming in and kind of looking at little swirl marks on a movement, I look at an Apple One, and with this technology, I see so much more.